Adre clau tule dreoch mau drea mau.
One
treketo mau. Mati ma namakul mayumu.
He likes his alone time though, and one
prit namisi wunam. Mati ma namakul mayumu. Digadre e.
Claims the last they saw Sol, he was headed into that dune heap.
Prit namisi wunam. Mawagia maucha. Lemakul pigeon.
When a wehewele egwehish enkum.
Time to turn stuff you don't want into stuff you do.
Della lava lace, bratri, puta.
Could trade your old things for new.
Guba habodi.
Bara joy tarai.
Amazing to see so much happening today. Let's see. There's nothing good coming out on the other side of this tunnel.
Thank you.
keep on tracking down here and things will look up eventually. Who's going to step up to you now? A great thing, even better. Worry about stopping later. Feels like a monster's lair down here. Keep your feet beneath you. On your own. Up on your own 2 feet. Smirked. Ready to ride. There's a place and time for everything, but for that city scenario, it's already come and gone. Look both ways, look always. Thank you. Mount up. Keep those stompers on the straight and narrow. That over there is Steepo Depot, the cliffside that Moog hangs on to.
But see, in more, Diava.
Let's see. This one's impressed to see you out here. He figured you'd be dead by now. Not many are as tough and clever as you must be.
Kalba.
Says he's a monster haunter. The best you'll ever see.
Kukakwana.
Moog says that all your power doesn't do you a bit of good if you're not willing to pull the trigger when the time comes.
Guga.
Choosing what to kill and what to spare are the most important decisions you'll make.
Over, bug, ah.
You might have a steady aim, but you need to be sure that you pick your targets with care.
Diava, why ad fulia haya?
It's hard to make those life or death decisions for others, but someone's got to do it. Otherwise, they'll do it themselves, and you know they'll miss.
Como uno shalafi?
Claims he mostly kills whoever he doesn't like.
Over, bug, ah, in mo.
Says it's wild that the world seems to be coming back, but he supposes that means more monsters for him to shoot. Wonders why you work so hard to keep things alive. Bullets help thin the herd instead. Says you should give up on working with the stubborn myriad. He keeps trying to put out their lights and they keep putting up new ones. He's afraid you're just as stubborn as them.
Intabadans.
But enough of that, right?
Intabadans. Echine dana undisavela.
He says the wildlife, nature, has changed and turned against us. Instincts of survival took over when the world changed.
Echine.
He's not sure about their veggie diet anymore, and if it's changed, who knows what it's done with the chemical composition of their body output. Right now, though, he feels he's come to a point where he's got a pretty clear idea on the whereabouts of monsters, both tall and short. Says as big as they are, the world is bigger. To find where they are, you need to see where they've been. Moog says you must learn to walk before you can run. It takes practice before you can call yourself a monster haunter.
La fea nuch.
Fortunately for you, he can help. He understands you need to start off with something small before you go big.
Bon kuntuf will see la bug.
There's no better place to start than a squip cave. Hunting down a couple of these little critters for yourself should keep you on your toes. Says it's not far at all. Fortunately for you, the squips seem to have acclimatized themselves to the otherwise uninhabitable dead zone. Back to your own stompers. Static! Good deal. Imagine. You you could just go to a place like this to get a proper meal back in the old world. Knock it down, Tom. We are lonesome animals that spend all our life trying to be less lonesome. Biohazard makes your skin crawl. It's like a whole different world down here. Wait, it's the Skvip Holaf. Place is just filled with critters. Smackdown! Well placed. Right out. Locked. Once the volatilization from the nuclear waste evaporated, a volatile gas rose through the soil and infested structures, even Toxinol's own buildings. So, in a way, they caused their own death. that'll come in handy. History is nothing but a series of stories. A criticrit. Feel that? That's death in your fist. You need to line up the switches so they match. Just a few moves left. Make them count. Bristles like the hair of one electrified. You need to line up the switches so they match. Good. That's enough electric current to initiate the actuators and activate the framework. There are brakes if you want them. In the old world, roads like this really led somewhere. Now, most of them lead to disaster. Imagine how this place used to look before the dead oil flood. The grease monkey's mecton is built sturdy, just like himself. He says that's enough squibs to sustain the Mecton's claw crane cannon with infinite ammunition. Well done. That's the special weapon he made to store the squibs in the Mecton. It will be strong enough to launch them at the Jumbo Puff. Gizmo's made vehicles before to confront the Jumbo Puff himself, but failed. But this time, it's different. The Mecton will be strong enough to do the job. It's time to put a stop to the World Eater now. Otherwise, he fears the damage it's caused to the tree already will be too much to handle.
What? He's on.
He asks you to not even think about taking on the Jumbo Puff on foot. You'll need the Mecton to do the job. Take his word for it. There's time to improve the Mecton before you confront the Puff. There are more wreck boxes out in the dead zone with gear you should be able to equip the Mecton with on your own. He got the idea to build the Mecton when he found a big crate containing the metal frame for something Toxinol had named an exoskeleton. Gizmo wants to help if he can. The surf is hypnotic. Leave it behind. Tread soft. That's a monster nest, if ever I've seen one. Who'd leave rubber scrap lying around like that? feel that thing thrum. Seems steady enough. Back to your own parlor. This is Hobbydunk, a homey little village. Let's see. Smells like seaweed. Shopkeeper. Rescued a bunch of squips, but can't find enough. Seems silly that these critters are. Claims the little critters just tear everything else apart, but don't actually eat it. Says the squips are wiki picky, but you should be able to find their food. The squips are getting hungrier by the second. You fixed those flame flies fast. Thank you. Wouldn't want to be behind that. Being over the waves beats being beneath them. Dismounted. One at half his health. There, you could probably make something glossy with plastic scrap. There they are. Now, catch them. You fixed those flame flies fast. The deeper the night, the darker it gets. Look how happy those squibs are. Look how happy those squibs are. The beast comes roaming around day and night, and they can't get any shut-eye. Believes the less hulks in this world, the better. Tells you to wait till they fall asleep, or go hunt it down, whatever works. Claims that the monstrous Fluff Hulk has to be around here somewhere. Hulks aren't easy to end. You're the only one with a prayer against that monstrous Fluff Hulk. Says they just want you to make it stop. There's some bouncy rubber scrap over there. The tribes need someone to unite them. Says it's better to be great job taking out that monstrous fluff hulk. The harder they fall,